Today, I'll show you how to integrate LNX and LNX squared. For these integrals, we'll use the method of integration by parts. We'll be using the integration by parts formula shown here. For those of you who need to learn more about integration by parts, you can click on the link in the top right corner to watch a video with detailed explanations and examples. To aid your understanding, I have highlighted the integration by parts formula in orange and green. Now, let's tackle the first problem, which is the integration of LNX. Integration by parts is used when you have two terms multiplied together in the integral. In the case of LNX, it may seem like we have only one term, but there's actually a hidden one that we need to bring out and apply the integration by parts formula, making an exception to the typical usage of the method. Let's designate LNX as U and 1 as V prime. If we were to consider V prime as LNX in reverse, then we'll need to find the integral of LNX to determine V. However, that is exactly the problem we need to solve. So we'll choose U as LNX and V prime as 1. As a result, U prime becomes 1 over X and V becomes X. Now, let's write down the right-hand side of the integration by parts formula. UV becomes LNX times X. And the integral of u prime v becomes the integral of 1 over x times x. Simplifying the expression, we get x times lnx minus the integral of 1 dx, which can be further simplified as x times lnx minus x plus c, where c is the constant of integration. Now, let's move on to the slightly more challenging integral of lnx squared. The integral of lnx squared can be tackled using integration by parts, as we have the same term multiplied by itself. For this case, let's take u and v prime as lnx, and u prime as 1 over x. Also, the integral of v, which is the integral of lnx, is the result we previously found, which is x times lnx minus x. Now, applying the integration by parts formula, uv becomes lnx parentheses x times lnx minus x. And the integral of u prime v becomes the integral of 1 over x times parentheses x times lnx minus x and dx. Expanding the first bracket in the expression, we get x times lnx squared minus x times lnx. And expanding the parentheses inside the integral becomes minus the integral of lnx minus 1 dx. Now let's expand the right-hand side of the integral into two separate integrals. X times lnx squared minus x times lnx minus integral of lnx dx plus integral of 1 dx. Using the previously found integral result for lnx, this expression simplifies to x times lnx squared minus x times lnx minus parentheses x times lnx minus x plus x plus c. Here, the green bracket represents the integral of lnx. Now, if we further simplify the green bracket, we get x times lnx squared minus x lnx minus x lnx plus x plus x plus c. Notice that we have negative lnx and x appearing twice each. So the final answer is x times lnx squared minus 2x lnx plus 2x plus c. Integration by parts is typically used when two terms are multiplied together. But as we've seen, can also be exceptionally applied when there's only one term involved. This exception applies not only to lnx, but also the inverse functions of sine, cosine, and tangent. Remembering this special method and application to these four functions can be helpful for exam preparations. I sincerely thank all of you who have watched my video until the end. As a beginner YouTuber, there are many areas where I can improve, but it's truly rewarding to have viewers like you. Your subscriptions and likes mean a lot to me. Until now, I've been your math guardian, Alex.